During the construction of the M74 motorway, an interchange was erected between Hamilton and Motherwell. The main contractors had their head office near Hamilton. The wall on the right of the picture is the boundary wall of the policies of the Duke of Hamilton. This has to be demolished to make way for the new road. Modern equipment makes child's play of a one-time laborious task. Entrance to the Ross Lodge, a temporary bridge is being erected over the Avon for the use of the contractors. At this period, the level of the river is low and traffic is able to cross without much difficulty. The Ross Pond was always a favourite haunt of fishermen, and despite the fact that it has now been drained, they are still hopeful, even if it means being knee-deep in mud. One of the most impressive pieces of equipment in use is the pile driver, which drives metal casings to a depth of from 80 to 90 feet. These casings are then filled with concrete to support the columns of the flyovers. Here you see one of the casings being hoisted into position. The first stages of the southbound motorway are now being constructed. They are making use of the bridge which we saw earlier, which is now complete. There would appear to be as much underneath the road as there is on top. During the operations, the power supply to Hamilton was carried via this transmission line. The piles have now been encased in concrete. During the whole period of construction, the flow of traffic never ceased, despite the fact that the authorities would appear to have used every road sign in the book. The first flyover is now well on the way to completion. Meanwhile, workmen interweave bars of twisted high tensile steel. This is for the reinforcement of the base of the columns of the next flyover. After the piles are driven in, their stability is tested by means of these concrete blocks, which are left on top for a period of time. The piles are designed to take 100 tons load and are tested for 200 tons. See the beginning of a footbridge at the Hamilton end. Is being diverted. The original idea hoped to avoid this, but as the motorway would then have separated Hamilton from the mausoleum, the plan was altered. Footbridges were not in the original concept, but had to be introduced because of the walking habits of the people in this area. In March 1966, severe flooding took place and caused a great deal of damage to equipment. The space between the plinths and the columns is filled with expanded polystyrene to allow movement of the columns under load. These columns are hinged. As you can see, this is a very lightweight material, similar to the material used for ceiling tiles. Final touches are put to the guide rails of the flyover. At last, the work is complete, and on a very cold morning in December 1966, the opening ceremony takes place. The Lord Lieutenant of the County takes his place on the platform with other VIPs, including representatives of the consultants and the contractors. The Secretary of State for Scotland, Mr. William Ross, performs the opening ceremony and cuts the tape, thus declaring the new motorway open. And so the first cars proceed along the M74. Let us now take a walk from Hamilton to Motherwell. As we pass the slip road and ascend the first footbridge. We can watch the southbound traffic